wanting? Okay. We should be back with volume now. I'm just gonna wait for us to repopulate again and for everyone to come and join us once again for evening prayer. Sorry about that. Let's give everyone a few moments. The software forgot which microphone I was using, so I had to turn it off and go back into the settings and do all that. So, and I think maybe most people are back. Our Bible readings this evening are Psalm 26, Jeremiah chapter 21, and John chapter 11. Hopefully we are audible and we can pray. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Let your ways be known upon the earth, your saving power among the nations. Blessed are you, Lord God of our salvation. To you be glory and praise forever. As we behold your Son enthroned on the cross, stir up in us the fire of your love, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and walk with you in newness of life. Sing praise to him who died for us and for our salvation. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God forever. That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful, let us pray with one heart and mind. As our evening prayer rises before you, O God, so may your mercy come down upon us to cleanse our hearts and to set us free to sing your praise, now and forever. Amen. Psalm 26. Give judgment for me, O Lord, for I have walked with integrity. I have trusted in the Lord and have not faltered. Test me, O Lord, and try me. Examine my heart and my mind. For your love is before my eyes. I have walked in your truth. I have not joined the company of the false, nor consorted with the deceitful. I hate the gathering of evildoers, and will not sit down with the wicked. I will wash my hands in innocence, O Lord, that I may go about your altar, to make hard the voice of thanksgiving, and tell of your wonderful deeds. Lord, I love the house of your habitation, in the place where your glory abides. Sweep me not away with the sinners, nor my life with the bloodthirsty, those whose hands are full of wicked schemes, and their right hand full of bribes. As for me, I walk with integrity. Redeem me, Lord, be merciful to me. My foot stands firm. In the great congregation, I will bless the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Our first reading from Jeremiah. Jeremiah chapter 21, verses 1 to 10. The word came to Jeremiah from the Lord when King Zedekiah sent him to Persia, son of Malchijah, and the priest of Zephaniah, son of Manasseh. They said, "Inquire now of the Lord for us, because of Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, is attacking us. Perhaps the Lord will perform wonders for us, as in times past, so that he will withdraw from us." But Jeremiah answered them, "Tell Zedekiah, this is what the Lord, the God of Israel, says. I am not to turn against the weapons of war that are in your hands, which you are using to fight the king of Babylon and the Babylonians who are outside the wall beside you. I will gather them inside the city. I myself will fight against you. An outstretched hand and mighty arm in anger and fury and great wrath. I will strike down those who live in this city, both men and animals, and they will die of a terrible plague. After that, declares the Lord, I will hand over Zedekiah, king of Judah, his officials, and his people in the city who survive the plague, sword, and famine, to Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, and to their enemies who seek their lives. He will put them to the sword. He will show them no mercy or pity or compassion. Furthermore, tell the people, this is what the Lord says. See, I am setting before you the way of life and the way of death. Whoever stays in this city will die before the sword, famine, or plague. But whoever goes out and surrenders to the Babylonians who are besieging you will live. He will escape with his life. I have determination to do this city harm and not good, declares the Lord. It will be given into the hands of the king of Babylon, and he will destroy it with fire." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. John chapter 11, verses 28 to 44. After she had said this, she went back and called her sister Mary aside. "The teacher is here," she said, "and he is asking for you." When Mary heard this, she got up quickly and went to him. Now Jesus had not yet entered the village, but was still at the place where Martha had met him. When the Jews saw who had been with Mary in the house, comforting her, noticed how quickly she got up and went out, they followed her, supposing she was going to the tomb to mourn there. When Mary reached the place where Jesus was and saw him, she fell at his knees and said, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." When Jesus saw her weeping, and the Jews who had come along with her also weeping, he was deeply moved in spirit and troubled. "Where have you laid him?" he asked. "Come and see," they replied. Jesus wept. Then the Jews said, "See how he loved him." But some of them said, "Could not he who opened the eyes of the blind man have kept this man from dying?" Jesus, once more deeply moved, came to the tomb. It was a cave with a stone laid across the entrance. "Take away the stone," he said. "But Lord," Martha said, the sister of the dead man, "by this time there is a bad odour, for he has been there for 4 days. Then Jesus said, "Did I not tell you that if you believe, you would see the glory of God?" So she took away the stone. Then Jesus looked up and said, "Father, I thank you that you have heard me. I know that you always hear me. But I said this for the benefit of the people standing here, that they may believe that you sent me." When he had said this, Jesus called in a loud voice, "Lazarus, come out." The dead man came out, his hands and feet wrapped with strips of linen and a cloth around his face. Jesus said to them, "Take off the grave clothes and let him go." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. I think it's at times like these, days like these, that we need to remember passages like that, where Jesus had so much compassion in his heart for the ones that he loved and even wept for them. And so it's okay for us to feel sadness, because the Lord feels sadness for us too. And so that gives us permission to feel sadness at times like this, doesn't it? We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you. By your holy cross, you have redeemed the world. Christ committed no sin. No sin was found on his lips. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you. He himself bore our sins in his body on the tree, that we might die to sin and raised to life in righteousness. By your holy cross, you have redeemed the world. By his wounds, you have healed. You have been healed. We adore you, O Christ. We bless you. By your holy cross, you have redeemed the world. Song of praise from Revelation. You are worthy, O Lord and God, to receive glory and honour and power. For you have created all things, and by your will they have their being. You are worthy, O Lamb, for you were slain, and by your blood you ransomed for God saints from every tribe and language and nation. You have made them to be a kingdom and priests serving our God, and they will reign with you on earth. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Let's spend a few moments in silence to offer our personal prayers to God. Have mercy on your people, for whom your Son laid down his life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, bring healing and wholeness to the people and nations, and have pity on those torn apart by division. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Merciful Lord, strengthen all who are persecuted for your name's sake, and deliver them from evil. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, look in mercy on all who suffer, and hear those who cry out in pain and desolation. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, bring comfort on those who are dying. Gladden their hearts with the joy of a vision of your glory. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. So let us commend the world for which Christ had died, to the mercy and protection of God. Most merciful God, who by your death and resurrection of your Son Jesus Christ, delivered and saved the world, grant that by faith in him who suffered on the cross, we may triumph in the power of his victory. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. So standing at the foot of the cross, as our Saviour taught us, we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. May Christ, who bore our sins on the cross, set us free to serve him with joy. Amen. And let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. And so go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. Why not share with us either on this thread or in the different groups that are around what you're going to be doing tonight, how you're going to be spending your evening and glorifying God in what you do.